गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस प्रेपरेशन ऑफ कोलाइड्स एंड प्योरिफिकेशन ऑफ कोलाइड्स. ओके, नाउ फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, हाउ मेनी मेथड्स आर देयर विद अस विद विच वी कैन प्रिपेयर कोलाइड्स. सो देयर आर थ्री टाइप्स ऑफ मेथड्स. फर्स्ट इज केमिकल मेथड, सेकेंड इज ब्रीडिंग्स आर्क मेथड, एंड थर्ड इज पेप्टाइजेशन प्रोसेस. So these three main methods are there with the help of which we can prepare colloids. Now let us first do chemical methods. So by chemical methods we mean that we will do some chemical process which will result in the formation of kaleidoscope. Now the chemical processes which are used, they are of four types: double decomposition reaction, oxidation reaction, reduction reaction, or hydrolysis reaction. Okay, so for example, let us prepare arsenous sulfide sole. Then it will be prepared by double decomposition reaction. Now what is to be done? Arsenous oxide is to be mixed with hydrogen sulfide gas and it will form arsenous sulfide sole. Okay, similarly sulfur dioxide when mixed with hydrogen sulfide gas, it will form sulfur sole. The process involved is oxidation. Similarly, if gold chloride is mixed with aqueous solution of methanol, then there is formation of gold sole and this process is called reduction. Similarly, ferric hydroxide sole can be prepared by the process of hydrolysis of ferric chloride in water. So these are different methods with the help of which we can prepare a particular colloid. Okay. Now let us discuss the second method. Second method is called Breedig's arc method. Now in this method what we do? In this method there is disintegration of metal is done. What we do? We do the disintegration of metal by the use of electricity. Okay. Now how it goes ahead, we will see. Now this process involves dispersion as well as condensation. So two processes occur in this. Dispersion is necessary for the formation of colloid and dispersion occurs after condensation. Now what is done? Colloidal sole of metals such as gold, silver, platinum, etc., that can be prepared by this method. Now what is done? Electric arc is struck between the electrodes of the metal immersed in the dispersion medium. The intense heat produced vaporizes the metal which condenses to form the particles of colloidal size. Okay, now see what is the process. You just see now. See, we want to prepare gold sole. Then what we will do? We will take these two rods of gold. Okay, then in whichever dispersion medium we are going to prepare, that dispersion medium we will take here. We will place these rods by separating by a very small distance. Okay, this is the small distance between these two. And these two rods will be connected with the positive and negative terminal of the battery to provide electric current. Now, this whole thing will be covered in an ice bath. Okay. Now what we will do? We will supply electricity and the electrical power will be very high. Because of that, what is going to happen? At this particular place where they are separated by a very small distance, there will be production of spark sort of thing, and this will result in the vaporization of rods starting from this end. Okay, here they will start. Just like if you remember that if you are putting some shoe in a plug and that is not really tight, if it is a little bit loose, then what we see? Sometimes there is spark. So you can understand that like this only it is going to happen here. Because of that spark, these rods will evaporate. These will directly change into vapor form. Okay, now those vapors, they are surrounded by ice bath. So what is going to happen? Those vapors will readily condense. and they will convert in liquid form, and that liquid form will be mixed with dispersion medium, and then this will result in the formation of gold sole. Okay, so what are the two processes occurring in this case? We are maintaining electric arc is maintained. Because of electric arc, what happens? Our metal undergoes vaporization, and when those vapors undergo condensation, they get mixed with the dispersion medium, and this results in the formation of colloidal sole. Okay, so this is the main thing which occurs in Breedig's arc method. Now third method is peptidization. Now what we do in this case? Peptidization word may be derived from precipitates. Okay, so what we do, we take some precipitates, we mix those precipitates with suitable electrolyte, and what happens, in that suitable electrolyte there will be some ion which is common with the molecules of precipitates. Okay, because of this similarity, what it will do, it will get adsorbed on the particles of precipitates, and because of this adsorption, the size of the particles will increase, and that will range from 1 to 1000 nanometer, and once the particle size comes in this range, then we will say that it is a colloidal sole. So here in this example, when we take precipitates of ferric hydroxide and we mix it with ferric chloride solution, then ferric ion from ferric chloride solution gets adsorbed, and it results in the formation of colloidal sole of ferric hydroxide. Okay, so what this process becomes now? This process is the process of conversion of precipitates into some colloidal solution. Okay, so now one more thing, the electrolyte which we are using, that electrolyte is known as peptizing agent. Peptizing agent means that agent, that substance which is resulting in peptization. Okay, now what happens, what we said now, during peptization the precipitates adsorb one of the ions of the electrolyte on its surface. Okay, so it is very simple process. Peptization is the process of conversion of precipitates into colloidal sole particles by the use of suitable electrolyte. Okay, now when we prepare the colloidal soles, then those colloidal soles are not pure, there are so many impurities, so those impurities need to be removed. Now that process which is used for reducing the amount of impurities in the colloid is known as purification. So this process is called purification. Now how can we do it? There are mainly three methods: dialysis, electrodialysis, and ultrafiltration. So we are going to study these three processes here one by one. So very first is dialysis. So what is the process in dialysis? It is the process of removing of dissolved substance from a colloidal solution by means of diffusion through a suitable membrane. Now see, in dialysis process what we use a suitable membrane. Okay, now since particles in a true solution can pass through animal membrane or parchment paper or cellophane sheet, but not the colloidal particles, this membrane which we are talking about, it has the capacity that small sized particles can pass through it, but large sized particles will not pass through it. Means we can say that those particles which have size less than 1 nanometer are able to pass through it, but those particles with the size more than 1 nanometer, they cannot pass through it. Okay, so this process is called dialysis, and that particular substance is called this parchment membrane, or we say it is dialyzing membrane. Okay, Now, what is done in this? That apparatus which we are using, that apparatus is known as dialyzer. Okay. Now, in this what we do? A bag of suitable membrane is taken and colloidal solution is taken inside that. And then it is suspended in a vessel through which fresh water is continuously flowing. The molecules and ions diffuse through membrane into the outer water and pure colloidal solution is left behind. So what happens? Now see, in this diagram, we have taken a dialyzing membrane and we have taken sol which is impure inside, and then we kept the whole thing in a particular apparatus where there was running water. Okay, water was coming from one end, it was going out from the other end. So with the running water, molecules which are of smaller size, which are not of the colloidal range, they will come out from this through the parchment membrane or semi-permeable membrane, and then they will move away with the flowing water, with the running water. So this process is called dialysis. So what we will say, what is dialysis? Dialysis is the process of purification of colloidal sol by the use of semi-permeable membrane. And in this what we do, we take the substance, we take the sol, impure sol, in a parchment membrane, in a dialyzing membrane, and we put it in a beaker containing water which is running. Water is running from one end and going out from the other end. This stream of water carries away with it small sized particles coming out from the colloidal sol. Okay, so in this way it gets purified. Now what is electrodialysis? Now see, the process which we explained just now, that is dialysis. Now what is electrodialysis? So in electrodialysis, there are two things which are to be remembered. Very first thing, electro stands for electricity. So here we are going to use electricity. How we are going to use? We will be introducing two electrodes, cathode and anode, and we will connect it with the battery. And then the dialysis process will be repeated in the same way. We will take the impure sol in a dialyzing membrane, we will put it in the stream of running water, and then we will continue the process. And what is the use of electrodialysis? Because of the use of electricity, this movement, this migration of ions or particles will be done hurriedly. This will move on a stronger speed, it will go on very fast. Okay, so with the help of electricity, the process of dialysis is enhanced. It takes less time for dialysis to occur. Okay, so this is the only use of electrodialysis. So what we said here, since we are using electricity and this process is therefore known as electrodialysis. The process is same, only difference is there is use of electrodes. Those electrodes are connected with battery, and because of this electric current, the movement of molecules from the sol particles to the running stream of water becomes fast, and so dialysis process occurs fast. Now we come to third thing. Third is ultrafiltration. Okay, now see, just like filtration we say, here it is ultrafiltration. So in filtration we use filter paper, in ultrafiltration we are going to use ultrafilter paper. Now what is ultrafilter paper? Ultrafilter paper is prepared by soaking the filter paper in a colloidal sol. That colloidal sol is prepared from nitrocellulose. Okay, that colloidal sol is prepared by 4% solution of nitrocellulose. So this 4% solution of nitrocellulose we will take in a beaker, and then we will soak our filter paper in it, and once it is properly wet, then we will take it out and we will dry it. Then after that we will harden it by putting it in the formaldehyde solution. Then in formaldehyde solution, when we are going to put it in formaldehyde solution, then what is going to happen? Its size of pores, pore size will decrease. So because of decrease in the pore size, it will not allow the heavier molecules, more sized molecules to pass through it. Okay, so ultra filter paper once prepared is used for filtration of the impure colloid sole. So when we use impure colloid sole with ultra filter paper, then what happens? Those molecules which are having smaller size, less than the colloidal range, those molecules will come out. Okay, they will get filtered, but all the colloidal sole particles, they will not be separated, they will remain on the top of the filter paper. Okay, so this is the one of the method to purify our colloidal sole. Okay, now see, just like filtration takes more time, this ultra filtration also takes more time. It is a slow process. In case we want to increase the speed, then what is to be done? One pressure pump or suction pump is to be used. So with the help of suction pump, it maintains vacuum, and because of that, the filtration process occurs fast. Okay, so what is to be learnt now? Ultra filtration is the process in which we use ultra filter paper for the filtration process, and that ultra filter paper is prepared from nitrocellulose. We take 4% nitrocellulose solution, and in that we merge our filter paper, we soak it in that solution, and because of that, what happens? It becomes wet, and then we harden it by putting it in the formaldehyde solution, and then it results in the decrease of pore size, and so it doesn't allow the heavier sized particles to pass through it. Okay, so now whatever we have discussed today, on the basis of that, you have to solve these home assignments. Okay, thank you.